every day, no matter what I do, no matter where I am, Spirit is there ready to communicate.
Hi, how are you? Can I have a iced coffee decaf, please? Just with a little bit of skim milk?
There is not one place that I do not go that I do not give a message to someone.
I'm a psychic medium, and I don't know what it is, but are you, like, going through a lot, or I feel like that.
I'm going through a lot,
okay.
Yeah.
It's gonna be okay. Your grandmother passed? Who's the mother figure
for you? My grandmother passed.
Is your mom here today?
My mom is here today.
Oh, okay, because your grandmother's going, where's my daughter? Where's my daughter?
She's going like, because she's emotional.
Go get her. Where? Go like this. She could go like this, exactly like how I did it.
Ah, hello.
Hi.
Wow, all right, this is some nail place. What is this?
She's having a glass of wine.
Oh my God, wait, I don't know about this place. I'm gonna live here. I mean, are you kidding me? This nail salon is insane. You get to sit on a throne and have a drink and get a pedicure. Can you drive my car? Who can drive my car? Can someone drive my car?
I think I want a glass of wine.
We're gonna have to come back here. What, listen, who's driving my car to the next thing? Because just like driving, I cannot drink and channel responsibly.
Morning, hon.
Hi, hon. Good morning.
What's going on?
How are you?
When I first told my husband, Larry, that I was a medium, I don't know what he was thinking.
I just thought she was crazy.
Despite the fact that Larry and I are divorced, we still are communicating, and it's so important because we have kids together. Oh, geez. So weird. Hey.
How you doing?
Being that Larry is in California, I think it's important to keep him involved and up to date on what's going on with the kids.
You're outside.
I'm in the backyard, see?
How the boys doing?
They're good. One died. But it was the small one, not a big, you know, not the big one. It must be a new baby one or something. I don't know.
Okay.
But talking about babies, can you believe our baby's getting married?
I cannot believe it.
Everyone knows how special Victoria is to me. So words can't express how happy I am for her. And Michael has really shown not only Victoria, but myself, how fond and how much he's in love with her. So it's a beautiful thing.
We're gonna be in-laws.
Listen, we gotta get through this wedding first. I can't even get through this engagement party.
Did we have an engagement party? I don't even remember.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Really? Yes, don't you remember?
Teresa, it was like 100 years ago.
We had it at the Knights of Columbus. And I wore that really nice dress with the rhinestones, and it was the cow print and the tight short skirt.
I remember everything, but I don't recall the engagement party.
Do you remember that we got married?
You can't just keep going up to people. Like, not always people want to be read.
Well, what am I supposed to do? I got to walk around like this? I'm a nervous wreck.
You know, like me ignoring a spirit, do you think Victoria would ignore either a text from her boyfriend or a pair of shoes in the store? No.
I'm trying, Victoria, but it's not as easy as you think.
It's extremely annoying because then I get embarrassed and then she gets nervous because she doesn't know if she wants to talk to them or not. So it's just like a whole big show.
If you're gonna say something, say it now.
I don't know if I can.
That's honestly terrible.
Well, terrible for me, but not terrible for the people that I encountered.
True,
so it was a lot. I did not realize it.
I think it was a terrible idea that my mom didn't shut Spirit off all day. She looked drained. She didn't really have that much makeup on. She just looked not herself.
So I get up, I walk down the stairs. I end up reading Jimmy and Pat.
No.
Swear. Then I go to the gym. I end up reading Joe Galletti.
Oh my God.
Okay.
Was he in like tears?
Almost. He held it together. And then I met Sandy for coffee. I got you guys breakfast.
I know my mother's psychic, but sometimes I'm very extra cautious just because I never know what she could pick up.
If I'm lying or stuff like that, she definitely knows. So it kind of sucks.
Larry, I just want to, are you going to be around Friday night?
Yeah, I'll be home.
Because Donna and Mark are coming over for a barbecue.
It always turns into a big group session whenever we have people over.
We're going to have a group of people over.
Yeah, exactly.
Where do you have to always, you're like your father, you always got to zing.
It's just free of charge.
Give me a zinger. Free of charge, that's right. Free readings.
Larry, are you gonna do a toast?
I'm gonna make the speech.
He's such a good boy. Sorry.
On behalf of myself and Leah, I'd just like to thank everyone for coming out, traveling all the way to the city. I know it took a while to get here. I know we're all proud of Leah. She's beautiful, she's smart, and I'm speaking for everyone when we say we love you, and we want to see you prosper and grow professionally and with me.
If Larry proposes to Leah now, my mom will go insane.
Oh, hint, hint.
That's not a proposal, but we will raise our glasses.
To Leah.
To Leah.
Salud.
I mean, they've only been together for a decade. What is it gonna take? 2 decades?